You're here for a video about Pokemon Home and the future of transferring Pokemon between games and franchises. So stay tuned and we'll get right into the video. Before I begin today's video, I'd like to shout out my video sponsor for today, and that would be Samurai Buyer. Well, they didn't technically sponsor the video. They did send me this giant pink Mew plushie, which looks really, really cool and will fit my decor very, very well. My daughter absolutely loves it, and I can't thank them enough for sending it over. Look, Samurai Buyer is a Japanese proxy website that allows you to buy tons of different Pokemon stuff from Japan and have it shipped here to the US. If you're interested in seeing what they have, you can check out their website and search at your leisure. Maybe you'll find something that you like, maybe you won't. And it's under new management, so you'll probably be taken aback by the better customer service. With that said, let's jump into today's video. Yeah, so recently Game Freak decided to give us some information about Pokemon Home, Pokemon Bank, and all these transferring systems that they have. Basically, they're taking Pokemon Home and wrapping everything into it. And of course, Bank still had to exist because it is a precursor to Pokemon Home. I don't understand why we could not just have one unified GTS system to begin with and just keep it at that. But hey, whatever. I'm not the one who made it all. This video really is just focusing more along the lines of the price and the service that you actually get from it rather than what it actually is itself. What it is simply just a transfer system, convoluted as it may be. It still allows you to transfer your Pokemon from eShop versions of Gen 1 all the way up to the most recent generations and everything in between, which is really, really nice if you think about it. Prior to this, you would have to use all sorts of legacy devices, and then you introduce the DS and you would no longer need cables, and you couldn't use the cables anyways if you had them because they don't interface between themselves, and it was just a whole nother convoluted mess. Here's the thing though, when it came to trading between games, all you really needed was a link cable and that was it. All the Pokemon were on the game and you were able to trade them. Here, Game Freak is asking for no more than $16. That's just $16. For literally pennies a day, you can transfer your Pokemon. And I just want to emphasize that. It's so cheap. It's such a great service, right? Do I sound like I'm trying to sell you something? Because that's exactly how it sounds to me. It sounds like people are trying to sell me this. Oh, it's so cheap. It's such a nice service. You get to hold so many Pokemon in the club. See, here's the thing, man. I never once asked for a system where I could just put all my Pokemon into this magical cloud area and keep them there for whenever I wanted them. I have a game for a reason. I have a 30 PC slot that hold 30 different Pokemon in it. Sometimes they're bigger, sometimes they're smaller, depending on the game. You know, in the older games, it was 20 and you could hold 20 per box. That's a lot of Pokemon you could just put in the PC. What is the issue? I don't understand it. Why do I need all of this space? Even if I'm a shiny hunter, even if I'm looking for perfected Pokemon, why do I need all of this space for all of these Pokemon? Why can I not just hold them onto a game and then trade them over? If Pokemon Bank worked effectively and it allowed me to trade to the modern day games, then why would I not just keep Pokemon Bank and use it as an intermediary between good old Ultra Sun, Ultra Moon, and just keep two cartridges for the Pokemon I wanted to get from the games prior to that and then trade them back and forth? See, but that's not the thing that irks me the most. A lot of people try to defend the service by saying, oh, it's just $16. It's just $16. Yeah, absolutely. It's just $16. It's just my Netflix payment. Oh, but that's just for a year. Absolutely, it is for a year. And okay, I get 1 month of Netflix or I get a year of transferring my Pokemon. You're paying to transfer digital monsters for a service that will inevitably be discontinued in the future. It's not going to stay around forever. Digital things don't stay forever. That's just the nature of the beast. So whenever this does eventually end, whenever it does change and oh, we're upgrading to Pokemon Universe or Pokemon Evolved, and this is the new transferring service, all the money you spent on that previous transferring service will be lost. You just pissed it away to transfer digital monsters that don't exist in your world. There is no physical, tangible digital monster. I could spend $16 on a Pokemon plushie and I will have that Pokemon plushie for 20, for 30, for 40 years. I could give it as a gift. I could spend $16 on this. I cannot physically hand it to someone and say, here's your gift. Okay, I understand that it's the modern age and things are done a little bit differently. I'm sure there's going to be some type of gift option. Oh, I gifted you a year of Pokemon Home. Yeah, thanks, man. That's sweet. And I understand that there is a section where there's going to be the ability to try it out free for a month. That's great. That's what a lot of drug dealers do. They give the first hit is always being free. You know, get you hooked, man. Did I seriously just relate Pokemon to drugs? I think I did. And I did it effectively, too. Wow, that's crazy. It's almost like it's not Pokemon, but marketing, and really smart marketing. It's like Nintendo's been around for a minute or something, and they know how to manipulate their fans into spending money. Right, like companies aren't our friends. Like, Game Freak is not my personal friend. We're not going to the bar, and we're not getting a drink. So for those out there who sit there and argue, oh, it's just $16, man. What are you, poor? Why not go get a job? This mentality of everything needs to be free needs to end. I don't want it free. I didn't want it to begin with. I wanted a comprehensive game where I could store all my Pokemon, catch all the Pokemon to begin with, and be able to trade my Pokemon. Whether it's online or not, that doesn't matter to me because I barely play online with people and I barely trade online with people. I have way more fun trading locally with my family and friends than anything else. And that's what Pokemon was supposed to do. Bring people together. That's why the link cable existed. That's why they used it in the way they did when they created the game itself. But it is not just $16 though. That's the argument that's going to constantly be made. Oh, it's just $16 a year. And yeah, Nintendo Online is around $20 a year. Depending on where you get it, you could get it maybe cheaper. Maybe you spend a little bit more, okay? You know, depending on your country, depending on the exchange rates, whatever. Maybe you catch a sale. I know there's a Tetris game you can get Nintendo Online for free, so that's cool. But you still have to pay for Nintendo Online to use this effectively. Who's going to sit there and not get Nintendo Online but also have Pokemon Home? Who does that? No one's gonna do that. Then you have to add in your internet bill. How much do you pay for internet each month? Maybe very, very, very low end, $20. So let's say Nintendo Online is $20. Let's say your internet is $20. And now we're adding in Pokemon Home. That's $56. Now, Nintendo Online and Pokemon Home alone are $36 a year. That's what's going to cost you. $36 a year. And your internet bill, let's say, very cheap end is $20 a month. That means you're paying around 240-ish, 250 plus the 36. So you're almost paying $300 for three services that work all together to allow you to digitally transfer your Pokemon here and there. When I started playing Pokemon for a very long time, I want to say all the way up till Generation 4 when they had the GTS mechanic implemented where you could trade online. I had never fathomed that they would ever make a system that would unify all the Pokemon games to allow you to transfer your Pokemon between them. Am I complaining about the price? Do I think it would be better free? I am extremely annoyed that people try to defend this action like it's something good. Oh, servers cost money because of electricity. Yeah, congratulations, they absolutely do. And I, again, still did not ask for that. And I am not going to be purchasing it. I'm not going to be using it. I should be able to transfer my Pokemon from Pokemon Go via Bluetooth onto my Nintendo Switch, which I can absolutely do with Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee. And you know what it cost me? It cost me nothing. I don't need to use Pokemon Bank. I don't need to use Pokemon Home. We have so much transfer technology within our phones, within the 3DS, within the Nintendo Switch, within our Wi-Fi connections, and we're sitting here and we're trying to make one unified service that literally doesn't even need to exist. It's great that I can transfer my Pokemon from Pokemon Go to Let's Go Pikachu. So then, let me trade them over to good old Ultra Sun and Moon. Don't allow me to trade any Pokemon that don't exist in Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee back and forth. Can we not do that? Do we not already have that going on? It would be cool if they removed the stupid convoluted mini-games that they were doing for the Pokemon trades. But at the end of the day, am I willing to pay $16 for that? Absolutely not. I'm just pissing away money on digital content. To summarize this video, Nintendo fans will instantly raise the flag and condone all of these game companies, all of these developers, for implementing microtransactions, for implementing games as a service. Tons of people hate EA and that phrase that they coined, games as a service. They will condemn these actions that these developers take and then defend Nintendo because it's just $16 a year, which is incredible hypocrisy. I would be willing to pay $16 as a down payment. I would be willing to pay $40 for a Pokemon Home cartridge that housed every single Pokemon I could ever want, and to be able to trade them into that. But I would not be able to pay $16 a year to consistently maintain digital monsters in a portfolio. How long am I going to be a hardcore Pokemon fan who's going to need to keep all my Pokemon in the cloud? How long? How many years? And to waste $16? Is it cheaper than the price of going out for dinner? Absolutely. Is it cheaper than most games? Yup. It's cheaper than even a lot of the cheaper indie games out there. Yes. But you're still paying for a service that just transfers digital monsters. Something you could have done free previously. Something you could have done free with your phone between Let's Go Pikachu and Pokemon Go. Something you could have done previously with the 3DS wirelessly. You were able to do it with the DS wirelessly, and you were able to do it with a Link cable and with the Game Boy. And now you have to pay for it because it's this amazing magical service that's come on, and it's just going to revolutionize and change everything. I don't know. I don't know if I buy it, folks. What about you? You go ahead and let me know in the comments down below, and I would greatly appreciate you sharing this video by liking it or just letting other people know I exist. I've been your host, Pernamar, and I'm signing out. That's some food for thought. Would you be willing to pay $16 for Pokemon Home? Would you be willing to pay around $36 a year to use it effectively with Nintendo Online? And would you be willing to combine that with your internet payment? Perhaps go out and buy a Nintendo Switch and the Pokemon game that you would like to use it with as well. It's a lot of money to be spending on a Pokemon hub. You let me know in the comments down below. As always, good gaming, God bless, and I'll see you in the next one.